Hi, and welcome to Hitogify. Today we're going to look at KISS rare gems. More rare gems. This is a part two of two. And who knows, there could be a part three. Starting off, we're going way back to KISS's second album, Hotter Than Hell. All the way. I think this is a fantastic song. I've been a huge fan of Hotter Than Hell. Third listen, you're just into that album. Everything from Strange Ways to Got to Choose, two favorites on there, Parasite and Watching You, absolutely fantastic songs. But this one, All the Way, it's just a great song. The chorus line that that you just keep talking loud, the part about that way to your mother and father, and just one of those, I don't know if it's those pretentious or whatever, I like the vocal narrative. I say this over and over. I like what he's saying about, oh my god, I can't believe you're treating people like that, people you should show respect to, or whatever. I just, what I'm saying is I like the song. It's always been a favorite. I think it really rocks, and the chorus just rolls really well. I think I'll get a lot of blowback on this one. Dangerous. It's one, I did not like Sonic Boom as much as Monster. But there's a couple songs on there. The first track, fantastic. And this is another one of my favorites. Dangerous. I've heard people criticize the Danger You, Danger Me, Dangerous, the double entendre he's playing there. I think it's fantastic. Why didn't somebody else think of it sooner? That's what I've thought since it first came out. So it's funny how it hits one person as, like, completely cheesy and somebody else not, whereas there are some songs that I'm just like, okay, that's stupid. And other people, that's my favorite song. We'll get into that in future videos about ones that I just, rather than rare gems, it's going to be KISS's worst songs. And some of them will end up being people's favorite songs. Whatever you like, whatever I like. From Animalize, back into the non-makeup years. Animalize, Get All You Can Take. Absolutely love this song. I remember when I was a kid reading through the liner notes and noticing they didn't put the F word in there, but the F word's in the song. Ooh. When I was, I don't know, I guess I was 14 when it came out. That was just the coolest. For whatever reason, I thought, ooh, cuss word. Whoa. Anyway, I love the vocal line on that. I love the Paul writes, he does it also in, on the same album, on side B, Hit the Highway Doing 69 song. Hate that line. Under the Gun. In Under the Gun, it does this groove line. He does it many times. It's pretty much the basis of Keep Me Coming. But he'll play with some of those, and he just finds these notes. And I think that's a great song. And it for me, that mirrors the opening track, I've Had Enough. That dual feeling. I think he was in a real place where he was getting screwed, he felt like. I think he was both jealous that Gene was doing the movies and also hurt and that he wasn't contributing equally or whatever. And it just put him in a mindset to write these songs. I don't think the songs are about that situation. It's just turmoil, you know, spawns creativity. The next one, and I know people like this song, but I don't think it gets enough talk. From Asylum, King of the Mountain. Awesome song. I like the drum opening. It's not that typical, the drummer's trying to show off. He was just doing some, you know, little drum fills, just playing. And it's a great start, and some of the stuff, the backing vocals in they kind of bring the song down into the bridge and come out of that, it's fantastic. If you get a chance and you haven't heard it in a while, listen to that song and just look. The production is terrific, especially for a KISS self-produced one, which sometimes have some weaknesses. Hot in the Shade, I'm talking about you. The next one, The Devil Is Me. It is the sister song to I'm an Animal. But I still like it. I like when we hear a Gene song that he's the demon again, as opposed to some of the 80s stuff. We just lost some of that. Life's a Trial by Fire, and which is not a very hard song, you know. That's a trial by fire, which I actually like the song, but that's not the demon, you know. That would have been a great song for Eric to sing, I think. Actually, his voice would have taken to that really well. And Gene wasn't needed for it. Segue, anyone? Shout Mercy. I think this song's fantastic. That and Long Way Down, that it's just a combo of songs that I really love. That and Back to the Stone Age, those songs are fantastic on that album. But Shout Mercy, I know some people don't like the hoo-hoo. I like it. I think it adds to the song. I think it's cool, and I love when they try something different. I love when it fails miserably, and I love when it sails. I just like things that break it up. I'm just not into that. It's, you know, you've got to be heavy and cool, man. And I think I've enjoyed Kiss so much for so long because they're just flat-out fun all the time. Even Carnival of Souls, which, again, people don't like, but I might do a head-to-head with that and Revenge, because I'm the opposite of most people on my take on those two albums. The next one up, we're going back to Lick It Up, Dance All Over Your Face. I love that song. I think it's that Gene does that same thing again, where he does that. It's not quite a... it's not quite a canon where it rolls over, but you know he puts out the dance word, dance, 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 all over you. I'm gonna dance, all over you, and just it rolls around in a really cool way. It's fun. I always think of that, and I like the slower parts that almost are a smoky blues kind of thing. Dun 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 dun, dun. No sad memories. No, I'm just. I like it. That's a good song. It's atypical of a Kiss song, it seems to me. Going back to Makeup Years, but the very end of the Makeup Years. Not the very very end. Dynasty. Magic Touch. Love that song. I've always loved it. I love the vocal bridge. I love that they shifted the one thing. It starts with the chorus, which doesn't happen that much. One rare thing that's done a lot is people will start with the bridge, and then they'll go through the verse, pre-chorus, chorus, and then the bridge will come up again. This one just starts with the chorus, and that's pretty rare. That doesn't happen that often, and... I just love the riff. Down, 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 down. That's a great song to me. Love it. And Lesser Known. It's just one of those that we don't talk about that much. Back to the last side of the studio side of Alive 2. All American Man. Love it. Doesn't get the... I don't think it's mentioned as much because the other songs on that side are so fantastic. It's hard not to listen to, not to bring up Larger Than Life or Ace. I still think Ace's greatest song is Rocket Ride. Oh my gosh, that song comes in my head all the time. But to talk about more of the rare tunes, All American Man is a great tune. I like the narrative take on it. I love the solo, which you can find a clip of Bob Kulick before he went insane, and how he recorded that. It's great. Great track. Love it. It's so much fun. All right, and finally, the last song that I'm going to bring up, again, back to Makeup on Unmasked, Naked City. That is the best track on that album, and I like a couple songs on that album. So it's not my favorite album. I don't like a lot of the tracks, or they just don't fit with me. And other ones I do, they do take me back quite a bit. I was really into Kiss when that came out, and I wasn't in a position or I didn't require them to be heavy to like them. So I just like the songs, and they're really well constructed songs. Like, there's just more Ace songs on it, although those are some of his weakest songs. But Naked City is absolutely fantastic. That is definitely the best Gene song on there, because I cannot stand She's So European. What else does he do? You're All That I Want. It's okay. I kind of like the part when Paul jumps in at the end. It's a cool trail off. But Naked City is the best song on that album, and it puts it in a good company with a lot of great songs. It's just a really cool song. Definitely a notch above everything else on that album. And that's because I don't mind the production on that one, where I do mind the production on some of the other songs on that album. It holds up a lot better. I just think it's more of a... Well, of that era, it's not hampered by it's from that era. It's not hampered by those things. Just the way recording was and that type of music. It doesn't feel as dated. The keyboard sounds aren't like, oh, so disco was over and you're still using that kind of feel. So anyway, I'll just give a list of these again. We have All the Way, Dangerous, Get All You Can Take, King of the Mountain, The Devil Is Me, Shout Mercy, Dance All Over Your Face, Magic Touch, All American Man, and Naked City. Again, I think it'd make a really cool mix. It'd really be out there. I'm going to probably make a mix of both of mine and put it on and just put on for a few weeks and see what I think. And maybe I'll come back and say, wow, was I wrong? Or... best, just awesome mix. It's just a little different than all the others. And there's, like I said, I will be able to make another one of these, I'm sure. Because there's so many just rare gems. It's not like they haven't recorded a lot of albums. Anyway, thanks for tuning in. Please like, please subscribe. And most important to me, conversation, comment. If you go, oh my god, dude, what are you thinking? That song sucks. Or they all suck. Or I've always liked that one too. But the rest of yours are stupid choices. Any of that. Or just throw out yours. What is your Kiss rare gem? I'd love to hear that stuff. I just like to spur this discussion. So thanks for tuning in to Hitogify. And I'll see you next time. And who won't? And I'm using the wrong track. Guys, back into non-makeup error. Error. Yeah, it's the sixth.